Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Today we are going to study the osteology of the body. In osteology, we have to study the different bones, like the hip bones, after that the femur, and after femurs there will be a tibia, fibula, and the foot also. In osteology, you know that we will study in different patterns, like first of all we need to know the type of the bone, and after that we need to know the side determinations that on which type of bone, which side of the bone is, and after knowing the side of the bones, we need to know the general features. In general features, we have to study the borders, the surfaces, and angles of the bones like that, and after that we will study the specific features. In specific features, we will study the muscles attachment, that on which surface, on which borders the muscles are going to attach, and after that we will study the clinical anatomy of the bone. So, starting from the hip bones, you know that what type of the bone is. So this bone is a hip bones, and on the unilateral side, but we see it that this is a flat, long and irregular bone. If you see all around, you will see that this bone is long bones, and this is also an irregular bone. So this is long bone and irregular bone. This is a type of the bone. And after that, we'll see the side determinations. It has three parts. If you see in detail, that the bone is in front of you, it has three parts: a large part, large expanded part, plate-like part. This is called the ilium. No, this part, this is called, this is called the ilium. Large, expanded, plate-like part. This is called ilium. And after that, ilium on lateral side, the outer side, there will be a hollow cup shape. Hollow shape, that's cup-shaped hollow. This is called the acetabulum. What is called acetabulum? So behind this cup shape, there is a foramen, large foramen. This is called as obturator foramen. So, it's made up of three parts. First of all, large plate part, that is called the ilium, and inferior anteriorly, inferior anteriorly, that is called a small portion. This is called the pubis. What is called? This is pubis. And posterior inferiorly, this bone is called as ischium. What is called? Ischium. So, this bone contains three parts. First of all, ilium. Second part is pubis. Third part is ischium. These three bones together to form a cup, hollow shaped cup, that is called as acetabulum. Okay, these three bones united at the level of this cup. Okay, so this is the type of the bone, and it is in three parts. Secondly, we have to know the side determination of the bones. We will study the side determinations, that how we will find that on which side of the bone is. So, starting from point one, this hollow shaped cup, it should be on the lateral side. Just hold this bone in your hands and place this cup, hollow shaped cup, on the lateral side. Second one point is that this is the plate like structure, which is flat and expanded part. This should be on the superior side. This will be on the lateral side. So we can hold this bone like this. But second point, third point, which will make us clear that on which type of bone and which side of the bone is, that the thin part of the bones, which is called pubis, should be inferiorly. So this part of the pubic bone, which we should keep this bone on the anterior side, and the ischium should be on the posterior side. So by keeping the pubic on the anterior side and the ischium on the posterior side, and the flat on the superior side, and cup on the external side, on the lateral side, we can see this bone on the right side. This bone is of the right side. Okay, clear? Next, we are going to see the general features, starting from the ilium. As we know that we divide this bone into three parts: ilium, pubis, and ischium. So, first of all, we are starting from the ilium. You know, this ilium bone is a large plate-like part. Okay, it has an upper end and is also a lower end. The upper end is a large ridge shape, which is that is called as crust. What is that? This is called as crust. That is iliac crust. No? Iliac crust. And the lower end forms the upper 2/5 of the acetabulum. Upper end forms the iliac crust, and the lower end forms the upper 2/5 of the acetabulum. Okay. It has three borders, the anterior borders, the posterior borders, and the medial borders. It has three borders, and also it has three surfaces. Outer surface, that is called as the gluteal surface. Inner surface, that is called as the pelvic surface, iliac surface or pelvic surface. And the posterior, that one is called as a sacropelvic surface. That is called as a sacropelvic surface. So, starting from the crust of the iliac crust. If we see the iliac crust on the upper side, we can see that the iliac crust horizontally, it is convexed. It is convexed upward. So, if we see from the upper side, we can see that the surface of the upper crust, it looks like a convex. Okay? And its maximum peak point, the maximum height of the convexity, like this, this point is lies just behind the middle of the iliac crust. The bone is called the iliac crust, and this is the peak of the iliac crust, upper part of the iliac crust, is placed on behind the middle of the iliac crust. Secondly, the iliac crust is divided into two parts. The ventral part is more than 2/3, okay? And the dorsal part, which is almost less than 1/3. Okay. The ventral part of the iliac crust, this one, the iliac crust, is divided into two lids, the outer lid and also the inner lid, and the intermediate iliac. Okay? So you see clearly that it has two lids, the outer lid and also the inner lid, and also and in between there's an intermediate iliac. So the iliac crust on the ventral tile, we have divided into two lips, outer and inner, and intermediate area. And also the dorsal part of the iliac crust is divided by a lateral and median slope by a ridge. Clear? Next, it has three borders, the anterior borders, posterior borders, and the medial borders. The anterior borders start from the anterior superior iliac spine. Now this point is prominent point. It is called as the anterior superior iliac spine. So just after the end of this iliac crest, there will be a posterior superior iliac spine. Front point is called as the anterior superior iliac spine, and the behind end point is called as the posterior superior iliac spine. So anterior border starts from the anterior superior iliac spine, runs downwards forming a notch, and after that another eminence, another projected area, that is called as anterior inferior iliac spines. Clear? Anterior superior iliac spines, a notch, and after that anterior inferior iliac spine, and now it continues with the pubo-iliac eminence. This is called the allopubic eminence. Here, this one is the anterior border. And second one is the posterior border. If it starts from the posterior end, it is called as a posterior superior iliac spine. After that, it runs downwards, another projected area, that is called as the posterior inferior iliac spine. So, and posterior superior iliac spine, and after that, there is a posterior inferior iliac spine, and runs downwards forming a big notch, that is called the greater sciatic notch. That's called the greater sciatic notch, and also continues with the superior border of the ischium. Clear? This one is the posterior border, and this is called the medial border. Medial border starts from the just behind the two-thirds of the ABA crest starts, it runs downwards and continues with the sacropelvic surface. This is called the medial border, and it also divides the iliac surface to the sacropelvic surface. So this one is the called anterior borders, posterior borders, and also the medial border. As you know that it has three surfaces, you know, the outer surface is called as the gluteal surface, the inner surface is called as the iliac surface or iliac fossa, and the posterior after medial border, this is called as the sacropelvic surface. So, the gluteal surface starts from the anterior borders to the posterior border. This is called as the gluteal surface. This surface is divided into four parts by three gluteal lines. This surface, gluteal surface, is divided into four parts by three gluteal lines. So, where does this exist? This one is the posterior gluteal line, starting from the dorsal part of the posterior superior iliac spine, just in front of the posterior superior iliac. This one is the posterior superior spine, just in front of the posterior superior iliac spine. The line runs downwards till the upper part of the greater sciatic notch. This one is the upper margin of the greater sciatic notch. So, in the middle point of the upper part of the greater sciatic notch, this line is drawn from the just in front of the posterior superior iliac spine till the upper part of the greater sciatic notch. This one is called the posterior gluteal line. Okay. Another line is the anterior gluteal line. Anterior gluteal line starting from the, you know that on the outer lip, 5 centimeters or 2 inches from the ventral surface of the outer lip, it runs downwards, and at the middle of the greater sciatic notch, runs downwards at the level of the middle of the greater sciatic notch. This is called the anterior gluteal line. Third one is the inferior gluteal line. It draws from the anterior inferior iliac spines to the peak of the, this one is the notch, the peak of the notch. This line is the inferior gluteal lines. So the posterior gluteal lines, the anterior gluteal line, and the inferior gluteal lines, these three lines divided the gluteal surface into four parts. Another surface is called as the iliac surface. The inner side of the surface, this is called as the iliac surface and also called the iliac fossa. Okay, third one, from the anterior border to the medial border, this surface is called as the iliac surface. And after that, the third surface is called as the sacropelvic surface. The sacropelvic surface lies behind the medial borders. So this surface is called as a sacropelvic surface. It has two parts. And the upper part is the rougher elevated area. This is called as the sacropelvic tuberosity. And the another part that is clear, and it also attached with the sacrum of the spine to form the sacroiliac joint. Okay, the eminence is non-articular, and this point is the articular to form the sacroiliac joint. This is all about the general features of the ilium. Okay, in next lecture we will see the specific features of the ilium, and after that we continue. Thank you.